morning, everyone. Buenos dias a todos. Thank you for joining us today in this very significant ceremony to honor Mexican origins, symbols, culture, and traditions. As we celebrate the 7th edition of Mexican Week with many diverse activities that I'm sure you are all enjoying very much. I especially want to acknowledge the presence of a great friend of Mexico, Major Jim Kenney, who has demonstrated to be a tireless promoter of diversity and a defender of the immigrant community here in Philadelphia. Thank you very much. Also, thank you very much to all the other dignitaries, our city representatives, friends, and fellow citizens. I also want to thank the students of San Veronica, that I know that you guys are out there. And students of Farm Church School, thank you very much for being here. I'm pretty sure this is going to be a very educational experience for all of you. Now, I would like to call upon the Honorable Jim Kenney, Mayor of the City of Philadelphia, to invite him to come closer to the podium.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Buenos dias. I'm excited to be here with all of you today to raise the Mexican flag over our great city. Philadelphia has been and will continue to be a welcoming city for all. It is essential to our growth and to our prosperity. Each year, we hold many flag raisings to celebrate and honor our diverse communities. And today I'm thrilled to recognize our vibrant Mexican community. There are several thousand Mexicans and Mexican Americans living in Philadelphia who work, attend our schools, run excellent businesses, are good neighbors in our communities, good parents, and contribute widely to the prosperity of our great city. Over 100 Mexican companies have chosen Pennsylvania as their home, creating over 8,000 jobs in our state. We want you to know that we are proud that you call Philadelphia region your home. Today's ceremony is also part of the Mexican Cultural Center's annual celebration of Mexican Week, which runs from today until May 6th. It brings me great joy to be part of this week-long celebration. Thank you to all the Mexican community for everything you do for our city. And before I conclude, I would like to take a moment to thank Council Kerber for her commitment and partnership with the City of Philadelphia. Let's give her a hand. Council Kerber is head council of Mexico in Philadelphia and has been a career member of the Mexican Foreign Service since 1991. Council Kerber also served 49% of the female migrant population and worked to ensure that women benefit from the many services offered by the consular representations of Mexico. And she has been recognized for her dedication to the Mexican community. In March 2019, Mexican President López Obrador proposed that Consul Kerber become Consul General of Mexico in Houston, Texas, and we're going to miss her very much. Later in that month, she was duly ratified by the Mexican Senate. On behalf of the City of Philadelphia, congratulations, Consul Kerber. We wish you the best of luck as lead consul in Houston. Now I'd like to formally present Consul Kerber with a citation for the City of Philadelphia in honor of her outstanding contributions to our community. And lastly, I want to present you with this Mexican this proclamation on behalf of the city declaring May 1st to May 5th as Mexican Week in 2019 in Philadelphia. I just want to say to all assembled here, we're happy you're here. We're happy that you chose our city. We will continue to protect you and support you. Despite what you hear out of Washington, we got your back, and we're never going to stop having your back. You have changed our city for the good, for the better. Keep on doing it. Keep on expanding. Bring your relatives here. We want them all, as many possible people as we can, to fill our city. Viva Mexico.
Thank you very, very much, Major Kenney. Next, Consul of Mexico in Philadelphia, Alicia Kerber, will share a few words with us on behalf of the Mexican government.
Thank you very much. Welcome to this wonderful celebration in this gorgeous day, a very Irish day that they will call Gorgeous Day. So thank you very much for being here today. Today we celebrate the Mexican Week, which coincides with the commemoration of the Cinco de Mayo battle, a battle in which the most powerful army in the world was defeated by underestimating the capacities of a country who was capable of facing adversity, having as its main weapon its pride and its courage. Today, I also want to express my recognition to Mayor Kinney by standing up and making Philadelphia the city of the Fourth Amendment, where every migrant can feel secure and welcome. Thank you, Mayor. By doing so, you have proven that the U.S. is really the land of the free and the home of the brave. At your office, we have always found people committed with their work and sensitive with the situations faced by those who live in this wonderful city. And this can only be the reflection of who leads a great team. My gratitude to Councilwoman Maria Quiñones and Councilman David O, Mark Sequila, Al Taubenberger, and Councilwoman Helen Jim. Also my thanks to Stella Hess, city representative, who were always willing to give their support to the Mexican community and to participate in our events, honoring their conviction on the importance of diversity and the benefits of a productive bilateral relationship between Mexico and the United States. Today, I want all to say so long to Philadelphia before moving to Houston, where I have been appointed as Consul General. During these 3 years as Consul, I have had the opportunity to meet extraordinary leaders of the civil society organizations from whom I have learned their commitment to work passionately for their ideals. To all of them, you, my special thanks. Your support, solidarity, and friendship has allowed us to strengthen the work that we do at the consulate. To the lawyers who collaborate with the consulate, my sincere gratitude for always being there at the precise moment to defend the rights of the Mexican community. In an era where we know the price of everything, but the value of nothing, we need to continue fighting in order to grant access to justice for everyone and to see that due process be really respected, no matter your nationality, your gender, or your religion. To the members of the academic and private sector who were always willing to collaborate with the consulate, thank you so much for helping us emphasize that the bilateral relation between Mexico and the United States goes beyond immigration topics. Together, we have been able to highlight the importance of the commercial relation, where 6 million jobs depend on the trade agreement. More than $1 million per minute are trading the border, and that in the last 2 months, Mexico has become the first trade partner of the United States before China and Canada. This means that NAFTA too needs to be ratified. To all of my paisanos and paisanas, thank you very much for allowing me to serve you from the consulate, especially to those that encouraged me to work on behalf of migrant women, who, by the way, represent 48% of the total migration population. Be sure that I will continue working for you no matter where I am, but never forget that regardless the current rhetoric, you have made important contributions to the economic development of this country, and that the bad hombres are not us, but those who do not recognize these real facts. My special recognition to the members of the Mexican Cultural Center for their commitment to promote one of the richest cultures in the world. Your work has turned into the best tool to share our values, history, and traditions. But above all that, you have helped us build bridges of knowledge among communities. Likewise, my sincere thanks to all the team of the consulate that accompany me during these years of service. The good results presented will never be the achievement of a single person, but the sum of efforts of committed professionals. Special thanks to my husband, Luis, for being a firm believer in parity and my number one cheerleader. However, remember what the saying says, men go to the left because women are always right. Let me just finish by saying that those who think that Latinos are a minority group really know nothing about us. We have the strength, we have the courage, but most of all, we have the pride of who we are. Thank you all, and thanks, Philadelphia. I will miss you. Thank you all.
Consul Kerber, Major Kenny, thank you very much. Now, let's stand to the singing of the Mexican national anthem by the distinguished band La Carcaña, as the Mexican flag is being raised. Guys. Now I would like to ask Consulwoman Maria Quiñones to come to the podium here with us.
I'm going to ask my council allies and friends to join me at the podium. Felicidades a toda la comunidad mexicanos y nuestros aliados que se encuentran con nosotros durante esta celebración. I have to do a shout out to St. Veronica's because it's in the 7th Councilmatic District. And Jamie Nettis, can we hear it? El primo. Felicidades a toda la comunidad. Quiero darle el agradecimiento a nuestro alcalde, Jim Kenney, que ha demostrado a través de su liderazgo un compromiso no solamente con la comunidad latina, pero la comunidad mexicana en particular, dado la situación que hemos visto nacionalmente. Él ha sido un firme aliado a que nos ha apoyado en todo. Thank you, Mayor Kenney. De parte del Consejo Municipal tenemos un reconocimiento en particular por nuestra cónsul. Yo siempre he tenido una buena relación, extensa relación con el consulado, pero en particular con la consulada porque ha sido una mujer tremendamente preparada, firme, una que ha apoyado a abogados no solamente para la comunidad mexicana, pero sino para los derechos de todas las comunidades que se han sentido bajo la presión nacional. Personalmente, de parte de mí, cónsul, como la única latina en el Consejo Municipal, te he agradecido el apoyo, la firmeza que tú nos has demostrado a todas las comunidades inmigrantes en la ciudad de Filadelfia. Le quiero agradecer al equipo del Consulado Mexicano que a través de su apoyo hemos tenido éxito tanto en el esfuerzo de Language Access y en particular con el esfuerzo de Municipal ID. I want to thank all of the team of the Mexican Consulate who worked with the Mayor's Administration and Council to implement the program that has been tremendously successful. There he goes. Ay, el alcalde ya tiene. If you don't have yours, you better get one. Get an appointment because it's been a tremendous success. But the Mexican Consulate and the staff and the team were incredible allies in helping us develop that program in a way that could be successful and beneficial to all. So with that, I'm going to ask all my council colleagues to join me in reading the resolution by the Council of the City of Philadelphia.
Recognizing and honoring Consul Alicia Kerber for her service and dedication to the Mexican community throughout the city of Philadelphia. Whereas born in Mexico City, Alicia obtained a bachelor's degree in law, a master's degree in international law, and a doctor's degree in international public law, all of them at the National Autonomous University of Mexico. And whereas, after completing her diplomatic training, she was appointed advisor for the Coordination for the Environment and Natural Resources at the Mexican Ministry of Foreign Relations. And?
Whereas, Consul Kerber has represented Mexico as Officer for Political Affairs at the Mexican Embassy in Colombia, Consul of Mexico in San Pedro Sula, Honduras, and also served as Deputy Representative of Mexico before the Organization of American States, Washington, D.C. Ms. Kerber has also served for 2 years as Deputy Head of Mission at the Embassy of Mexico in Ireland. And whereas?
Consul Kerber served as Head of the Consulate of Mexico in Kansas City, Missouri from August 2012 to June 2016, with jurisdiction over the states of Kansas and Missouri and the western half of the state of Oklahoma. She promoted the creation of the first window of integral attention to women, which results allowed this program to be institutionalized in Mexico's 50 consulates in the United States. And whereas Consul Alicia Kerber is currently the head of the Mexican consulate in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, in the jurisdiction of Pennsylvania, Delaware, and Southern New Jersey, and
whereas, as Consul Alicia Kerber was instrumental in coordinating not only this flag raising, but the many activities throughout the city of Philadelphia, Mexican Independence Day, which is held in September at Penn's Landing, and as I mentioned earlier, an incredible asset in the creation of the Philly City ID program, giving marginalized communities the opportunity to obtain an ID from the city. Whereas we in council commend Alicia Kerber for her continued commitment to the Mexican community in Philadelphia and thank her for her strong advocacy, her achievements, and wish her well in all her future endeavors. Further resolve that this resolution be presented to the consulate as she leaves to Houston on us for her service, her dedication to the people of the city, and extend our sincere respect and admiration of this legislative body. Muchísimas gracias, Consul.
Thank you so much.
All the best where you're going. And please, I'd like to stay in touch with you. You never know, I might get down to Houston.
You can go to Houston.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
thank you all. Thank you all for this great recognition to Consul Kerber. And well, finally, I will kindly invite the president of the Mexican Cultural Center, Araceli Guenter, to join me at the podium and say a few words.
Thank you. Thank you. On behalf of the Mexican Cultural Center, thank you very much for attending. This was a very emotional experience. So we, as a board, would also like to recognize Consul Kerber's commitment to the board, the energy that she brought forth, and also in her leadership in terms of propelling this organization forward to continue doing even more than what it has done up until now. And with the support of the Mexican community, as well as the Mayor Kenney, City of Philadelphia, the council members, we will definitely succeed in that mission. And it gives me great pleasure as a closing ceremony to introduce to you our very own Yaretzi Mexican Folkloric Dance Group. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for being here. This is the end of our program. Thank you to Grupo Yaretzi. Thank you for, for Band La Carcaña. If you could please just give us one more song, that'd be great. Thank you all.
Thank you.